Yeah, in winter if you come up here, all this will be died down, see? You'll be able to see the hillside. There's something brown in there. I just see if there's a head of a deer sticking out, because they do hide, you know. Right in there, what's that? Oh no, it's a bit of light. Let me see, look, looking back now. See, the sun's starting to go. But we're not far, we're not really far. It always seems a long way. That little woman, I bet I met this morning, that old woman, I bet she did her 4 hours exact. I bet she did. And that's good. I mean, she was 76, I think she said, which doesn't seem old anymore to me. Now I'm 65. Hear the babbling brook, everyone? Wordsworth and Coleridge's brook. I don't feel better when I'm out, you know. I really do feel so much healthier. All right, this time it's giving me time, only just. Once we hit the wood proper, it's really not far. It's just this meandering bit going down into the Coombe, following the stream. Oh, I'll have to catch up with EastEnders later. I don't even know if there's any programmes on. I normally watch on a Thursday, I don't know. I watch Who Do You Think You Are, but I can't remember what night that's on, but I can catch up on it. And I won't have a lot to eat tonight. No. Be too late. When I go to Tesco's, I might just get myself a... Well, I can either make myself a sandwich, buy some ham or something. Or tongue. I'm just beginning to feel a bit peckish now, because basically I've got a packet of crisps still and a chocolate cake, and I've been living on junk all day because I never bought any fruit bars. I've got my oranges, of course. I've still got an orange in my pocket. Where have I? Yeah, I have. Now we're coming into the wood now, the gnarled ancient wood. Look at that tree there. Hi tree. You've seen me for years coming here. Years. My lovely trees. You've seen me for years, man. Look at you, my lovely oaks. A bit of water anyway, you'll get some more tomorrow probably. A little bit of a stream there, look. I'll keep quiet now. I'm going to try and keep quiet because the deer might be hovering. They hear my big gob, they run away. They'll know I'm coming anyway. Sometimes you've got to keep your eyes peeled because they keep dead still. You could miss one, but they won't miss you. They'll spot you a mile off. Thank you. the old ancient trees. The spirits of the trees. My little voice as a child was here. The trees were there. As will I. Now look at this, isn't this beautiful, everyone? With the green and the trees. I mean, they look so much happier in the summer, the trees. I tell you what, in the winter they really, really look dead. Hi there. They really, really look dead in the winter. Their leaves aren't spectacular or anything, but it just makes difference. When I was a kid, we used to go up the hills to look at the big ant hills. I haven't spotted any for a while, but I suspect they're still there, probably more concealed. Here's a brook again, trickling down from the hill. Yeah, we used to paddle and play in the streams, build little dams. Every summer at Eastover, we used to come up here. Not this particular coombe, but some people would wander over the hill, but the next one up. Trees. Look at that one. He's been here so long, haven't you? Hey? So long. I speak to the trees. I love trees. These trees are very special here. They pump out such much needed oxygen. It's just absolutely gorgeous, really. Yeah, well, like I said, I don't tend to see the deer here. It is up the other coombe, I'm afraid. So I think it's very unlikely, but I didn't want to come up that coombe this evening. I've done quite a bit of walking. It's much more overgrown than this one. This is well used, this one. The other one, not so much. Just imagine Wordsworth, though, in that. Actually walking here. 300 years ago. 200 or 300 years ago. He actually walks up here. I mean, obviously some of these trees might not have been here, but their parents would have been. I would have thought. I don't know why I brought the walking stick, you know. I haven't really used it. Here's a bone. Now, when I was a kid, I would have picked that up and took that home for me collection. And when I got a bucket full and bleached them, I used to take them in for me science teacher. Like I said, you don't normally see them aside. They're very, very territorial because I'm talking about years of them not being this side. Unless they do it in the middle of the night. Because it is a well-worn track, this one. And you get men out here with camouflage. And they make really good hides under these ferns, for example. to try and catch the deer and the other wildlife. They've got camouflage zoom cameras. They can even pick up, they could pick up what I'm saying. Those cameras. Oh. We just stop and look over there. Sun's doing the last big spurt. Saying, get on, Sheila. It's just come out with one last huge beam before it starts to fade. It often does that, see? It's letting out one massive beam, telling me to get a move on. I don't want it to end really, because I just love it here. This was going to be the place I had my ashes put. That had been the plan for a long time. But I decided to go to a more public place. Glastonbury tour. Where I can, there's views all around Somerset then. I mean, there's parts of Somerset I have not explored yet, to be quite honest. And I don't, they feel like another part of Somerset, or I don't feel I'm attached to at all. There's only a mild attachment to places like Frome and Shepton Mallet, for example, because my sister Barbara lived there. Jane Louise, John was a policeman in those areas. And but really, they feel like the other side of the hill, which they are. So I don't know if I will ever bother with those. You can't do it all. It's a big county. Right, we're coming down into more open space now, leaving the little Quantock, which is what Quantock stands for. Quantock means small pathway. Just going to turn off for a minute and take some photos.